Bruce Tough, principal of the Tough Law Firm. We are a full-service law firm serving the greater Woodlands area and the greater Houston area. Contact us at 281-811-0808. We're tough for you.
Welcome to The Legal Fix, a new age radio show brought to you by The Tough Law Firm. We're the toughest law firm in town, with the toughest lawyers around answering your toughest legal questions.
Hello, and welcome to The Legal Fix.
The Legal Fix.
It is a pleasure to bring you this show Friday, and I am absolutely in patriotic gear, feeling all American, boy wonder. Thanks to the Olympics and the amazing gold medalists that have come through. Today we have a couple of awesome guests on. Unfortunately, we still do not have our fearless leader, Bruce Tough, but G.I. Jerome, the super. What are those glasses? What are those?
I see the world through rose-tinted lenses.
Okay, so you're a beetle today.
It looks like it.
And we have a wonderful special guest on our show today, Joanne Linzer. Ms. Linzer is a board-certified criminal lawyer, certified by the Texas Board of Legal Specialization. She was also voted in 2019 as a top 10 American Institute of Criminal Law attorneys. She was a prosecutor in Grimes County, Montgomery County, and Tarrant County, and now she protects the defenseless in criminal defense attorney.
We like that.
Welcome.
Thank you. Thank you very much.
And she's also wicked
smart. Wicked smart. Absolutely. So tell me a little bit about this. What was it like being a prosecutor in Grimes County, Montgomery County, and Tarrant County?
It was such a great experience. I think that one of the things about being a prosecutor is that you get the opportunity to evaluate cases and see them from the very beginning to the very end of the process. And you get a chance to wear the white hat. Like, you get a chance to do some good.
Absolutely, and represent your community, right?
Yeah. And then,
as a prosecutor?
You do. But then on the defense, you get to do the same thing.
We like defense.
Yeah, absolutely. You get to protect people on the defense.
So what special knowledge did you gain as a prosecutor that helps you now as a defense attorney?
Well, I think that it is that. It's knowing how the process goes through how the prosecutors are evaluating cases. So kind of have an understanding of what case will end up based on the facts that you have in front of you and the history of the people that you represent.
You get the inside scoop.
You kind of get the inside scoop.
So today's episode is obviously going to be on criminal law, and Joanne Linzer is going to bring heavy-hitting facts on how to deal with your worst criminal issues.
Criminal law number one was how to talk to the popo, right? And Bruce had a lot of inside knowledge on that. Maybe not from personal experience. Maybe from personal experience. He had some very strong opinions. No comment about what to say, what not to say when you're talking to the police. So we went over a little bit. I'm sure you've watched all of our episodes, Joanne.
I have.
So
it was a requirement before you came on the show, so you better have.
Yes, future show guest, watch the episodes, especially the hot seat.
Especially the hot seat.
Yeah.
Insider knowledge. So today's episode specifically will be on pretrial diversions and deferred adjudication.
Adjudification.
Yes.
The way many pronounce it.
Yes.
So I think we might dive into a couple of other topics.
And expunges.
Yeah, we can talk about expunges and non-disclosures. Yeah.
Yes.
Something that goes in the toilet. Expunger.
Kitchen accessory.
So we will do a bit of home makeover and a little bit of criminal law work today, I guess.
All in one.
No net. we operate here with no net. So if you hear me stuttering, it is real and legit, and there's no take backs. All right. Well, before we go to a break, is there anything you'd like to add, Ms. Linzer, about yourself? Will you tell the audience a little bit about yourself?
Yeah, was a prosecutor for approximately 15 years.
15 years.
Yeah.
Wow.
And I prosecuted cases from, you know, marijuana, DWI, all the way up to sexual assault of children, murder cases.
Some serious stuff.
Went out on some scenes, at crime scenes, and had an opportunity to go through that. I taught law enforcement at Montgomery County, Grimes County, Tarrant County, and was awarded the Chris Marshall Award for teaching prosecutors how to be prosecutors.
Wow.
Yeah.
So well deserved, I'm sure.
Absolutely.
A lot of fun.
Did you consider yourself law enforcement?
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, sure did. I mean, a member of law enforcement, yeah.
Okay.
And what made you to decide to convert from the dark side
to the good side?
To the good side.
Criminal defense work.
You know, I think that every prosecutor kind of comes across that moment in their career where they want to get back to having more of a life, having more time with your family. And I'm a grandmother now.
No way.
Yes, I am.
What? Congratulations.
Yeah, congrats.
Thank you. And so I just kind of wanted, you know, slow down a little bit.
What do your grandkids call you?
Well, he's only 9 months, so he hasn't said anything.
What is the name
what do you
that
want?
You're going to be referred
Probably
by?
Probably Go-Go. Go-Go.
Oh, my goodness.
That
That's a great one.
Bruce is dancing.
Very unique.
Go-Go.
Yes. I'll even do that one. Yeah.
That's for Bruce Tuff, because we miss you.
Go-Go, Linzer.
There you go.
Very good. So I think we will cut over to commercial break. And when we come back, Joanne Linzer, you get to sit on the hot seat.
Oh, no.
Oh, yeah. See you on the flip side.
See you soon.
I'm Bruce Tuff, principal of the Tuff Law Firm. We are a full-service law firm serving the greater Woodland area and the greater Houston area. Contact us at 1-6-0-8-0-8. We're tough for you.
Time. Hey, you ready to donate?
Go to UPC. Subscribe at Radio 91.1 FM.
Time. Hey, you ready to donate?
Everyone loves animals. Even make them wear seatbelts. But not all people wear seatbelts, which is ridiculous because seatbelts save lives. Don't be a statistic. If you love it, click it.
Yo, yo, welcome back to The Legal Fix, where we have a special guest, Joanne Linzer, the super lawyer, and G.I. Jerome, the other super lawyer.
Hi-yo!
Carlos, we'll take him. Hi, welcome to The Legal Fix.
Welcome.
Hi there.
Hi.
Hi.
Welcome to The Legal Fix.
The Legal Fix.
My name is Anita, and I had a question.
Yes, Anita, what is your question?
So, I have an offense. And I wanted to know if I can clear it off my record.
An offense.
Okay. Okay.
Joanne, you want to take that one?
Sure. So it's going to depend on what it was that your offense is how it was disposed of. So if your offense was anything other than a DWI and it was a dismissal, then you generally have to wait for the statute of limitations to run. Then you can hire a lawyer to file what's called an expunction. And that they can file that with the district clerk. It's a civil case, and it takes place in Montgomery County in front of our civil judges. And you end up filing that. There's a time period to wait. The DA's office has to agree to it. DPS has to agree to it if it's prior to the statute of limitations. And if okay. they agree, then you could get it off your record.
So my offense was drug distribution. I ended up serving like 180 days in jail.
So that is going to be a felony. And because it's a conviction and it's a final conviction, you're probably going to have to deal with that being on your record.
Okay.
Is it causing you problems? Did you have a background check come back or try to rent an apartment?
Yes,
get a job?
I had problems getting a job and finding a place to live and, you know, all of that stuff. So,
yeah, that's okay. The unfortunate consequences that are outside of the time you spend in jail are those things that stay with you for the rest of your life. It's kind of unfortunate.
Okay, well, rehab has been great, so I'm just going to keep on moving on. Thank you so much.
Congratulations on rehab. Atta girl.
Wonderful.
Okay, thanks.
Thank you, Anita. Bye.
Kids, let that be a lesson. Don't sling dope.
No. Just say no.
Just
like
say no.
Ronald Hagen.
It's worth it.
Do we have a second caller?
Is there another caller?
Okay. Let's see if we can get that caller
Hello.
On the line.
Hello. Welcome to the Legal Fix.
Welcome to the Legal Fix.
The Legal Fix. Hello?
Hi there. I have a question.
What's your name, caller?
My name is Bruce.
The man, the myth, the legend. He lives.
Straight to Bruce.
Yeah.
Hey, how are those ghosts on the mountain, Bruce?
Hey, the mountains are glorious. It started raining today, but they needed a little rain. But I hiked the top of the mountain. It was like 9,000 feet.
Awesome.
With Diana, the honey badger.
And HBIC.
HBIC.
And I had Abby and Sydney get about 4 beers and ride the gondola up to greet me.
Bruce and the Moose.
A reward for all your hard work.
Yeah.
Bruce and the Moose. Hey, Bruce, I got a quick legal question for you.
Yes, fire away.
What's the plural of moose?
Wait, did you ask the question?
What is the plural of moose?
He's delaying.
But I can't hear you guys.
What is the plural of moose?
Moose.
Moose. The plural of moose.
Okay. Noted. I'm going to write that one down.
Moosehead.
Moosehead
is the one we travel all the time to go through the Grand Teton Park. It's an 8-mile road. And so we saw some.
Nice.
Did you pet one?
A moose and her calf. Yeah.
Do they have moose rides up there where you can ride on a moose?
They don't have moose rides. Those moose can be kind of testy. You know, they got a place called Bear World where you can go hang out with the bears, and it's in Idaho.
Bears.
But so far, no bear sightings. A lot of moose. Yesterday, I drove Abby to the airport, and on the way back, we crossed 22, and there was a herd of bison.
Nice.
Just kind of walking on the street. You know, what the hell? It's
Did the honey badger get after them?
No, Honey Badger was mad because I was taking him for another long drive to Coulter Bay. I can't stand it. I took him to Yellowstone. You know how it is in being trapped in a car with me for
with
3 hours.
With Bruce Tuff for 3 hours.
It would be lovely.
Bruce is going to get 15 angry client calls as soon as he hangs up.
Ed, I'm in charge of all the music. That's the part.
What music do you listen to, Bruce?
Well, I start out with classical, then Frank Sinatra, and then I go straight to 70s and 80s music. Yeah.
Okay.
And it's pretty. It loops. So it loops. So you get to hear it at least 3 times in a row.
Nice. Very good. Well,
yeah,
we miss
you. How's Joanne doing?
Bruce.
Yeah, well, miss you guys.
She's doing great.
Doing good.
She hasn't hit the hot seat yet, though. She's really anxious about
sweating.
That.
Okay.
She's
sweating.
All right, Joanne, you're going to have to do the hot seat. And we're going to see how you did, see if you can break my record.
I'm nervous.
I have a tough legal question for you.
She will be crushed.
This is going to be a hypothetical.
Okay.
If it's someone I know and they were at like a political function, cocktail reception, and had 2 or 3 small glasses of wine and was driving home and a police officer stopped him and said, "Sir, have you been drinking?" How do you respond to that?
Well, if it depends on the reason that you were stopped, but usually I would recommend that your answer is yes. And when they say how many, you say 2. If you really only had two small drinks or three small drinks, then you should be fine, pass the tests, and go on your way. But another lawyer sitting in the same seat might say, lie, it's none of their business, don't say a word, don't give them any evidence, and shut it down there. The thing is that you're going to be more than likely arrested if you fail the field sobriety test, whether you're honest or not.
Good deal. Good advice. That's somewhat consistent. Thank you, Joanne.
You're welcome.
Appreciate that.
You're welcome.
Well, Bruce, we've...
Okay, so how's it going, guys? Do you need me anymore?
Go back to your...
Go have fun with the meese.
The moose and the bison. We're Buffalo Roam.
All right. We're packing up. I'll see you guys tomorrow. Thank you, Joanne.
Sweet.
Later.
Bye, Bruce.
Bye.
All right.
Bye.
So, Lois, do we have enough time to put two on the clock? It's time for the hot seat.
Whoa, hot seat time.
All right, Joanne, how do you spell Linzer?
L-I-N-Z-E-R.
Is Joanne one word or two?
It's two.
Are you a ranch girl?
Yes.
Or a Thousand Island?
Oh, ranch.
How much do you weigh?
I'm pass.
Who's your favorite character on The Legal Fix?
That would be a tie between the two of you.
Attagirl.
That's
okay. What's the TSU Tiger rally cry?
Oh, I wish I knew it. TSU, I don't know.
Good.
How long does it take you to get to court?
Oh, gosh. Where am I going to court?
Montgomery County.
Across the street from your office?
Like a minute and a half.
Do you have a prenup?
No.
Why was Joe from OCO unsuccessful?
Because she ran against someone who had been running for a long time.
Attagirl. You're a member of the Texas State Bar College, right?
Yes.
Why did you skip summer school?
I didn't. I went. That information's incorrect.
Okay. Mm-hmm.
How often do you check your social media?
Like every other day.
Assuming you're the top dog, who's the second best criminal attorney?
Greg Gaines, my partner.
Do you look down on criminal law attorneys who aren't board certified?
Oh, absolutely not.
What's one thing that people don't know about you that you want them to know?
I'm afraid of clowns.
Rusty Harden or Tony Busby?
Rusty Harden.
How often does it take your dog to work day?
About once a month.
Were you a drill sergeant at Baylor Law Boot Camp?
I was.
Did you make people cry?
I don't think I did.
Are you a sorority girl?
Yes.
Have you cried in the last year?
Yes.
Month?
Yes.
Week?
No.
If you could be anything other than a lawyer, what would it be?
It would be a photographer.
What is recreational administration?
That is an easy degree from Southwest Texas State University.
Sum up your life philosophy in a word or phrase.
Be kind.
What percentage of your clients lie to you?
Oh, God. More than I wish.
Final question. Which the most time in the mirror?
Ooh, in the mirror. Vince Santini.
Oh!
Judge Santini.
Shout out Judge Santini.
Very
yes.
good.
You did
well.
Girl.
You did very well.
That was
great. I
didn't
count them, but you did awesome.
You crushed
Thank
it.
You.
So.
Nerve-wracking.
I think we're close to time for a commercial break. When we return, we will have interesting legal news from the week before and a little more information from Joanne Linzer on expunctions. And I have a couple of questions for you when we get back.
Okay, great.
Well, stay tuned for The Legal Fix.
USA. USA.
Time. Hey, you ready to donate? Oh, blood bomb!
How's your family if a wildfire shows up at your doorstep or blood or an earthquake? You can't just turn away a natural disaster. That's why it's important to go to ready.gov/plan now. It has the tools and tips you need to make an emergency plan with your family. So if disaster comes knocking,
let's go.
You'll be ready to help keep your family safe.
It's just a pizza.
Yeah. Make a plan today.
At WhatsApp, the number 936-981.
I'm Bruce Tough, principal of the Tough Law Firm. We are a full-service law firm serving the greater Woodlands area and the greater Houston area. Contact us at 281-681-0808. We're tough for you.
Hello, hello. Welcome back to The Legal Fix.
The Legal
where
Fix.
Where we have our special guest host, Joanne Linzer.
Joanne Linzer.
The super criminal lawyer. And Joanne is going to be talking a little bit about expunctions, deferred adjudications, and pretrial diversions.
Wow.
So before we jump into
thumbs
that.
Thumbs up on the pronunciation there,
yeah,
B-Dub.
Yeah, and we'll talk about plungers on the next episode.
How are those headphones fitting over there?
Yeah, they don't fit very well. Paula Hughes gave me this hat. Paula, I just want to say thank you for being so thoughtful always. And the hat, though it looks a little outlandish, matches my outfit, I suppose.
Joanne, you are snubbing the gift that we gave you from our office as well, right?
Yes.
Okay.
There we go.
Nothing like peer pressure live on the air.
Yes.
There you go. That's what we like to hear. So just to go over a little bit of news. Important legal news of
what's
the week.
Going on.
The Fourth Circuit Court of Appeals, the federal Fourth Circuit, has upheld a ban coming out of Ocean City, Maryland for women going around topless, stating that it is substantially related to an important governmental interest in protecting public sensibilities.
They're banning toplessness?
Yes, which for ladies might be a little offensive, but they have decided that it is constitutional and it does not violate the 14th Amendment's Equal Protection Clause.
How about dudes?
I do not think that we want to see dudes run around topless, but there's no law prohibiting it.
Interesting.
You may not want to see women running around topless either.
That's gender discrimination.
No, absolutely not. In other legal news, Britney Spears' attorney has filed to move up the conservatorship hearing date. His goal is to get her father off of her finances and out of her life completely after 13 years of his criminal reign. So, as I always say, free Britney. And then, Zoom's favorite video conferencing platform has agreed to an
Is that like Skype?
Yeah, what happened to Skype? Skype just fell off the map. As soon as Corona showed up, Skype was like,
that was their big opportunity.
I know, and Zoom and they blew jumped it. In there.
They I still it. Call it Skype when I can't think of the word Zoom.
So Zoom has agreed to an $85 million settlement in a class action lawsuit regarding the selling of private information to third parties like Facebook and for what they call Zoom bombings, which is where these people jump into Zoom meetings that are secured and hold it hostage. I think this is a pretty big deal, and we will see how this leads or where this leads. But
that's why your Zoom meeting password can't be 1234.
Why are you doxing me on? Come on, guy.
Did I just guess your password?
Ms. Freitag, will you please change the password to my Zoom? ASAP.
Oh, no.
Sheesh. Okay, so, Joanne.
Yes.
Jeremy has a few questions for you regarding pretrial diversion. But before we go to that, I have to ask you, what's the difference between an expunction and a non-disclosure?
So an expunction is something where once it's ruled on, the records are sealed or they're destroyed. And if the records are destroyed, then no one can access them later. Non-disclosure means that there are certain agencies that still have the ability to view those records. So licensors, agencies that provide licenses to people or law enforcement.
So governmental agencies
can still see those.
How did they destroy the records? Did they burn them?
I don't know. I mean,
shred them?
When I worked in Grimes County at the DA's office, we did shred them.
Bleach bit.
We would shred the records once we got the order, and that was gone. And that goes to law enforcement, the clerk, the DA's office. All of the people are supposed to destroy the records. And if they don't, there's a criminal penalty.
What if there's a company on the internet that has pulled that information from the reporting systems?
I hate those people.
They're out there. They're out there in the
it's
thousands.
It's so hard to get it scrubbed from those places.
If you get an expunction or order of non-disclosure, are you able to go after those private third parties to get them to remove it from their websites?
I have tried to get them to remove it, and their response to me is that it's out there and there's no way they can get it back. However, locally, we do have some places like, there, I know with certain, the newspaper and the Montgomery County Police Reporter, many times they'll bring it down once that case has been expunged, so the mugshot that was brought up will go away, disappear. Okay.
They're willing to do the right thing.
Yeah, they're willing to do the right thing. Yeah.
Very good.
There's a bunch of companies out there on the internet that don't update their records like they should every 6 months or however often they're required to, and they'll keep it forever until you threaten them.
People.
Yeah, that's pretty sad. So thank you for answering my question.
Sure.
Jeremy, I know you have a few questions you want to ask the Linzer.
Yeah.
The Linzer.
Earlier, our caller asked about expunction and you mentioned the statute of limitations. For our listeners that don't know what that is, what's a statute of limitations?
So criminal offenses have a time period in which the case can be prosecuted. And for some cases, it's 3 years, and for others, it's 5 years, and for some, it's a lifetime. There's no statute of limitations. So in other words, it could be prosecuted at any point in time in your life.
Murder.
And so you'll have to wait sometimes for the statute of limitations to run, which may be 2 years or 3 years on a misdemeanor before you can get your case expunged.
Okay. Something I want to talk to you about, when you're a first-time offender and you're really sorry for what you did and you're telling the court, please don't make me have a criminal record for the rest of my life, is there an option for people to not get convicted their first offense?
So in Montgomery County, Harris County, and some other counties, they have what's called a pretrial diversion. And that pretrial diversion is a program, it's a contract that a defendant and the state enter into, in which the defendant has to complete certain things in order for their case to be dismissed. But there's criteria, like you mentioned, if you're a first-time offender. On a DWI, if you complied and gave a sample of your breath or your blood on the scene, you didn't get into a wreck, no one was injured or hurt. So there's criteria that the DA's office looks at before you can even apply. And if you successfully, if you meet all the criteria and you apply and they let you do that, you have to plead guilty in order to start this contract. And as a result of that guilty plea, they kind of hold that to make sure that you finish everything. If you successfully complete it, then the case is usually dismissed. Sometimes there's a pretrial diversion that results in, when you're finished, you get a lesser charge or a deferred adjudication, something like that. But in most cases, it's for a dismissal. And that dismissal can later be expunged. So it's a great program. The problem is that you do plead guilty. So if you mess up, then you just go straight to sentencing in front of the jury, judge, or the DA's office.
Do you ever recommend to your clients that they not do pretrial diversion?
Yeah, I mean, there's always circumstances. I had an individual that lived in Oklahoma, and he was going to have to come back every month to report for the pretrial diversion. It didn't make sense for him, and so we went a different route to resolve his case. But it needs to be somebody that's really dedicated to finishing this stuff. So if you're in a place where your crime spree is not over, it's not a good idea to do a pretrial diversion.
So if someone has a type of offense that's eligible, can they come see you and ask you to help represent them and apply
absolutely.
For a pretrial diversion?
Oh, absolutely. And that's what I was going to mention earlier. It's really a good idea to have a lawyer in order to get the opportunity to do the pretrial diversion, because if you represent yourself, many times the DA's office is just going to tell you what the offer on the file is that they have, which is usually probation or jail time. And so it's really important to get a lawyer to represent you, because the lawyer understands what is available outside of those two options. And they also understand how to look at the case and see if there's any issues with, you know, the probable cause or the actions of the law enforcement officer that's alleging that you commit this crime.
Joanne, if they wanted to, say someone, Bruce's hypothetical man, he got caught by the police after his little cocktail mixer and got arrested, how is he going to reach out to you? How would he get in contact with you to help him?
I mean, definitely calling our office, 936-647-1946, and setting up in a consultation. I do free consultations for individuals and kind of go over what their criminal history is and where I think their case is going to go based off what they say.
So it's a free consultation?
It's a free consultation,
wonderful.
Yes.
And do you have a website they could go to?
I do, linzerandgaines.com.
Can you spell that?
LinzerGaines.com.
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 Very good. Mm-hmm. Okay, well, looks like we're coming to a close. Jeremy, do you have any final thoughts?
Joanne, it's been a pleasure having you on the show.
Thank you
very much for being our special guest today.
You guys are great.
It's been a privilege.
I love it.
Absolutely. Well, I guess we will close with that. This has been the most recent episode of The Legal Fix, our second round on criminal law with the special guest host, Joanne Linzer. Make sure to check us out every Friday at noon on The Legal Fix.
The Legal Fix.
The Legal Fix. And we will say goodbye. Next week, we'll have Bruce Tough back in town.
Yay.
And we'll have a very exciting episode for you guys. So
until next week.
We'll see
Thanks,
you then.
Thanks, guys.
in Lake Conroe, in Cleveland, in Splendora, in Porter, in New Caney, in New Waverly,